इदं सर्वमिदं महात्मा इति च प्रकृतस्यैव द्रष्टव्यस्य आत्मन एकत्वं दर्शयति। फर्दर ही सेज़ इदं सर्वमिदं महात्मा, इदं सर्वं यदं महात्मा, ऑल दिस एंड सच पैसेजेस आल्सो इज गिव वन मोर पैसेज ओवर हियर एंड सच सेंटेंसेस दैट दिस इज द ऑल दिस इज द सेल्फ ओनली 2, 4, 6 All this is the self only. Iti cha shows the ekatvam, unity of the self, which is under discussion. Prakritasyaiva drashtavyasya, which has been said, that which is to be realized. Atmavare drashtavya. And the same thing later on is said with the unity also. Therefore, we have to say that here there is no possible of Brahma Bhavi Purusha. तस्मात् न आत्मनो ब्रह्मत्व संपदुत्पत्ति ही दे फॉर हियर देर इज नो कन इन मेडिटेशन सेम थिंग इज मेडिटेशन ऑन आत्मा एज ब्रह्मन इज नॉट पॉसिबल संसारी आत्मा शुड नॉट बी मेडिटेड अपॉन एज ब्रह्मन देयर इज सेल्फ कैन नॉट बी रिगार्डेड एज सुप्रीम सेल्फ थ्रू मेडिटेशन बेस्ड ऑन रिजेंबलेंस टू गिव फर्दर रिप्लाई टू हिज क्वेश्चन एंड हिज थियरी Bhashyakara is putting an option now. Okay, even if you consider this to be a sampadupasana, meditation based on resemblance, then tell me this sarvabhava apatti, what is it? Phalam of upasana? You see, angry. Kincha sampatti paksha tad apatti phalam annyadva. Tad apatti, the unity with it, should be the result of this, or you accept something else as the result of upasana. इति विकल्प्य द्वितीयं प्रत्यय फर्स्ट द सेकंड से अन्यत् यू कांट से समथिंग एल्स एज द रिजल्ट न चापि अन्यत् प्रयोजनं ब्रह्मोपदेशस्य गम्यते बिकॉज वी कांट से दैट देयर इज समथिंग एल्स एज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस मेडिटेशन आल्सो और ऑफ दिस इंस्ट्रक्शन बिकॉज द रिजल्ट दैट इज मेंशनड ओवर हियर इज ब्रह्म वेद ब्रह्मै भवति अभयं वै जनक प्राप्तोऽसि अभयं वै ब्रह्म भवति इति च तदापत्ति श्रवणात् Therefore, we cannot say anything else to be the purpose of these instructions of the knowledge of Supreme Self other than unity, identifying with Brahman itself. Brahma Veda, Brahmai Bhavati. He who knows the Self becomes, he who knows the Supreme Self becomes the Supreme Self only. 3, 2, 9. Abhayam Vai, Janaka Prapto Si. And not only that, it is abhayam vai janaka praptosi. Abhayam. You have attained the fearless. O janaka, you have attained the fearless. That is free from fear. 4, 2, 4. Abhayam vai brahma bhavati. He whosoever now, in general, in the end he says, he whosoever who knows that Supreme Self becomes the fearless. 4, 4, 25. In the end it has comes. संपत्तिश्चेत् तदापत्तिर्न स्यात् बिकॉज इफ यू कंसिडर दिस एज अ मेडिटेशन बेस्ड ऑन रिजेंब्लेंस देन तदापत्तिर्न स्यात् आइडेंटिफिकेशन विद ब्रह्म विद द सुप्रीम सेल्फ इटसेल्फ कैन नॉट बी द रिजल्ट बिकॉज एनी टाइम मेडिटेशन डज नॉट आइडेंटिफाई 100% विद द मेडिटेटेड ऑब्जेक्ट ऑन विच यू आर मेडिटेटिंग न ही अन्यस्य अन्य भाव उपपद्यते बिकॉज अन्यस्य अन्य भावो न उपपद्यते वन थिंग कैन नॉट बिकम अनदर थिंग टोटल आइडेंटिफिकेशन जस्ट लाइक ए पॉट कैन नॉट बिकम ए क्लॉथ कैन नॉट बिकम ए पॉट सिमिलरली हियर आल्सो ए संसारी जीव कैन नॉट बिकम ब्रह्म एंड ए ब्रह्म कैन नॉट बिकम संसारी जीव नहीं अन्यस्य अन्य भाव उपपद्यते देयरफॉर तद आपत्ति मीन्स ऐक्यापत्ति न स्यात् यदि संपत्तिश्चेत् विगत दिस एज अ मेडिटेशन देन तदापत्ति विद द वननेस द यूनिटी कैन नॉट बी द रिजल्ट बिकॉज अन्यस्य अन्य भावो न उपपद्यते बिकॉज इट्स इम्पॉसिबल दैट टू से वन थिंग कैन बिकम अनदर वचना संपत्तिरपि तदापत्ति स्यात् गुरु इति चेत् नो बिकॉज श्रुति इज टेलिंग द रिजल्ट सो देव वाई डोंट यू एक्सेप्ट द रिजल्ट मेडिटेशन ऑल्सो टू बिकम आइडेंटिटी द यूनिटी Urpakshi says, वचना द वर्ड स्टेटमेंट श्रुति स्टिलिंग देयरफॉर यू शुड एक्सेप्ट इट इज गोइंग टू हैपन. शास्त्र से भाष्कर से नो मेडिटेशन जस्ट एन आइडिया संपत्ति है प्रत्यय मात्रत्व और मेडिटेशन इज जस्ट ए नोशन एन आइडिया मेंटल आइडिया ओनली एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी प्रूव्ड बिफोर दैट एनी आइडिया एनी नोशन एनी नॉलेज कैन नॉट क्रिएट एनीथिंग कैन नॉट चेंज इवन एन नेचर और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ एनीथिंग दिस वी हैव सेड बिफोर ऑलरेडी. इट जस्ट गिव्स यू अ फर्स्ट हैंड इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग अ थिंग अननोन. विद्याज्ञान निवर्तक व्यतिरेकेण अकारकत्व विज्ञान से अवोचाम. आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड बिफोर विज्ञान से च नॉलेज बिकॉज इज ऑलवेज वाज इज ऑफ विच टाइप इज इज वी हैव सेड ऑलरेडी बिफोर दिस अवोचाम. व्हाट मिथ्याज्ञान निवर्तकत्व इट ओनली रिमूव्स द फॉल्स नोशन अदर देन दैट इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू क्रिएट और चेंज एनीथिंग. अकारकत्व अवोचाम न च वचनम वस्तुन सामर्थ्य जनकम बिकॉज एनी स्टेटमेंट कैन नॉट इम्पार्ट एनी टाइप ऑफ स्पेशल पावर कैन इंड्यूस ए स्पेशल पावर इन टू एनी थिंग इट कैन इम्पार्ट अ पावर टू ए थिंग सो इट कैन चेंज इट कैन नॉट चेंज बट कैन गिव सम पावर टू इट ऑल्सो टू चेंज इवन दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉट पॉसिबल. भास्कर सेज वस्तुन सामर्थ्यजनक वचन न च वाई बिकॉज एज ऑलरेडी स्टेटेड ज्ञापक शास्त्र न कारकम इति स्थिति. इट्स एन यूनिवर्सल एस्टैब्लिश्ड डिक्टा दैट वी से वेरी क्लियरली एनी शास्त्र एनी इंस्ट्रक्शन एनी स्क्रिप्चर इज जस्ट ए ज्ञापक इट्स नॉट ए कारक इट्स ओनली इन्फॉर्मेटिव and not creative. Jnapakattam, it's informative only. And not karakattam, it's not a creative thing. Iti sthiti, this is the state. Because they give information regarding a thing unknown to us, and but they cannot produce anything. This in 2120, it will come in detail. 2120, this is now we are reading 1410. In 1410 you are studying this statement, but in detailed discussion you want to see it will be in 2120, in the end of the second chapter. Second chapter, first section, 2-1. Last one is 20. Lot of shastra is there. And around mainly 40-50 pages there also. Debate is there on this point. Sayesha iha pravishta ityaya vakyasya parasiva pravesha iti sitam. Not only that, besides this, another most important point is in the passage that is stated tasrishtva sayesh here sayesh ye pravishtah 1147 the self has entered into all these things ityadi vakya similar such statements tasrishtva tadan pravishat etc also can take taitri upanishad. What is stated is parasyeva praveshiti sitam. It is clear that the supreme self itself has entered into these bodies. Therefore, there is nothing called as transmigratory self different from the Supreme Self. Transmigratory self, what you say, is just an illusion. There is nothing in self which is, can be considered to be transmigratory. The self does not move at all. It is all pervading. There is no transmigration that you mention with regard to self. There, what is being stated as transmigrative self is foolishness. You can say individual self and Supreme Self. The word that you use, sansari atma, is totally, we are using here also, Vedantis also use, depending upon the purpaksha. But according to Vedanta, there is nothing called a sansari atma at all. Because that fellow has censored himself over here, and how he can become sansari? He is above sansara. Therefore he says, praveshiti siddham tasmal, brahma iti na brahma bhavi purusha kalpana sadhvi. This knowledge. Therefore, he says, the Supreme Self alone hasn't been entered over here. Therefore, the view that the word of Brahman in the beginning of this mantra, 10th mantra, denotes or refers to the transmigrative self who wishes or desires or is going to future become the Brahman, that idea does not stand consistent. That's not correct. Na sadhu, na sadhvi. That kalpana that thinking that your idea is not at all proper. Another reason he gives why not Brahma, the word Brahma is referring to Brahma Bhava Purusha. Ishtartha Badhana Cha. Ishtartha Badhana Cha. It contradicts the intended meaning of the whole context. How? He explains. What the context want to say actually? This Brahman is like Saindava Ghana. This Brahman is like Saindava Ghana. Vad, Anantram, Abhayam, Ekrasam, Brahmiti, Vijnanam, Sarvasyam Upanishadi, Pratipipadishito Artha, Kandadvayapi, Ante, Avadharanat, Avagamyate. He says, Saindava Ghana, like a lump of salt. Anantram Abhayam. Ekrasam Brahma. Interiorly, exteriorly. But what is only homogeneous? What is that? Etad Brahma, this Brahman, the Supreme Self. Iti Vigyan, this knowledge. This particular knowledge. About the Supreme Self. This is what is desired to be imparted by this whole Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Iti Vijnanam Sarvasyam Upanishadi Pratipipadeshito Artha. This Artha, Artha is Vijnan. This thing, this special knowledge is what is being intended or desired to be imparted by this whole Upanishad. And especially in this particular two khandas, which are with regard to the first chapter and second chapter together, one khanda called as Madhu Khanda, and the other two Muni Khanda or Yajnavalki Khanda, third and fourth chapter. These four chapters are totally Upanishad. Khanda Dvayapi, in this division of one khandas was one division, in each and every division, two chapters. In each and every chapter, there are many sections. The whole Upanishad is divided into three divisions. First division is Madhukanda, called as, second division is called as Yajnavalkanda or Munikanda, the last division is called as Khilakanda. And each Kanda consists of two chapters. We will not take the Khilakanda, there is no Brahmajnana charge, only Upas and other matters are there. All leftover things that has not been mentioned in this Kandvashagga, let's mention the last portion. All the leftover things, what has been left, small spaces left over to be spoken of before. In karma, upasana, and jnana, all those things are stated over there. The last two. Therefore, as you might have seen in that which I gave, the Shadlinga, that Brihadaranyaka, first chapter, second chapter, third chapter, fourth chapter. In fourth chapters I have given Shadlinga, all the four chapters. In fifth and sixth, no Kadrugi Shadlinga at all. There is no Brahma jnana at all. Why Shadlinga there? Only so upasana and how to give a beautiful child. A Veda, if you want to have a son who has a lot of Veda knowledge, what you have to do? Husband and wife, what they have to do, which Vedas they have to do the pata, what puja they have to do, and in which nakshatra, in which muhurta they have to get related, then that sun will be so and so. The white sun, yellow color sun, black sun, beautiful girl, scholarly girl, like that all those things will come in there. That's what is called Khilakanda, not related to Brahmagyan, or what is for grihasthas and others.
Why is it different?
Because in the beginning there is our some upasana related to which is necessary for a brahmachari. In sixth chapter, in the beginning, up to three brahmanas, that is how we teach. In sixth, up to fifth chapter we teach, and in sixth chapter, up to three brahmanas. After the three sections, from fourth to end, we don't. And we take the last one, the Vansha Brahmana. We chant the names of all the rishis of this parampara. In between, we don't teach at all. That's not necessary for us. But up to there, it's because brahmacharis were mukshus and all. For them, it's very necessary that the havan that's been stated over there to purify himself and all, to remove all the daily evils and other evils that happens to the body and mind and everything. Special havan is there for brahmacharis. That's necessary. Up to there, Bhashakara has also written Bhashyam properly. After that, it just very lightly touches and gives stuff. So there's here also, it says there's Kandadve, not Kandatre. काण्डद्वयेपि अवधारणा द टू डिविजन्स कन्सिस्टिंग ऑफ टू चैप्टर्स ईच वेर वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट द ब्रह्म ब्रह्मविद्या देयर आल्सो दिस व्हाट हैज बीन डिसाइडेड फाइनली अवधारणात अन्ते इन द एंड एट द एंड ऑफ देम दिस इज व्हाट द डिसीजन हैज बीन गिवन व्हाट इत्यनुशासनं बस ही सेड दिस इज ऑल द इंस्ट्रक्शंस रिलेटेड टू दिस ब्रह्म 3519 एतावत्तरे खलु अमृतत्वम् इति नो 2590 इन द एंड ऑफ सेकंड चैप्टर 2590 इत्यनुशासनं मीन्स 2590 दिस मच इंडीड इज ऑल अबाउट दैट इमॉर्टैलिटी ओ गार्गी ही सेज 4515 एंड द फोर्थ चैप्टर 4515 एंड 2590 सेकेंड चैप्टर्स एंड इज द एंड ऑफ द सेकेंड डिविजन फर्स्ट डिविजन ऑफ कंसेप्ट टू चैप्टर्स एंड ऑफ दैट विल बी 2519 द नेक्स्ट डिविजन इन विच द थर्ड एंड फोर्थ चैप्टर इज दैट द एंड ऑफ दैट फोर्थ चैप्टर इज 4550 तथा सिमिलरली नाउ नॉट ओनली देन द प्रधान उपनिषद कांडद्वय बट ऑल द उपनिषद्स दैट आर मेंशनड ऑल द शाखा एंड ऑल द रेसेंशंस Everywhere you have to understand the same thing he says. Tata sarva shakho upanishat sucha brahmaikatva vijnanam nishchito arthah. Similarly in the upanishats of all recensions, the knowledge of the Supreme Self's unity is what is being intended to be imparted to all the people. There is a certain particular import of all the upanishats. तत्र यदि संसारी ब्रह्मणो अन्य आत्मानमेव अवेदिति कल्प्येत वेन दैट इज द कंडीशन इफ यू गो ऑन मेकिंग दिस इमेजिनेशन एट दिस स्टेज ओवर हियर ब्रह्मवायु मगर आसी दिस पर्टिकुलर मंत्र विच इज मेंट फॉर ब्रह्म विद्या एंड स्टेटिंग देयर व्हाट यदि संसारी अ ट्रांसमाइग्रेंट सेल्फ इज देयर एंड दैट सेल्फ इज थिंकिंग अबाउट विच इज टोटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द सुप्रीम सेल्फ ब्रह्मणो अन्य संसारी And how he, what he is knowing? Atmanave. That sansari is knowing himself, that I am a sansari. And by that he is going to attain sarvabhava. How is it possible? Atmanave iti yadi kalpeta ishtasya artasya vadanam sya. Now brings back his reply. That's what he did the pratigya. Ishtartha vadana cha. Ishtasya artasya. Then what is going to happen? That which is desired to be imparted by this Upanishad. That will get forfeited it totally. Padram sya. That will be contradicted totally. And know itself, then the intended meaning of this portion, of this mantra especially, would be contradicted. Tathach, by doing so, what is the loss? The poor person may say, let it be contradicted. Give up your meaning. What I am saying, you take that. Then Bhashyakara says, if you say so, then shastra upakrama upasamhara yor virodha, then what do I have going to happen to upakrama and upasamhara? Because this mantra is 1-4-10 in the middle. We have said upakrama is 1-4-7. And then 1-4-15 is upasamhara. What's going to happen to those mantras? Can you conjugate according to this meaning the upakrama and upasamhara also? Can you change them? You can't change. Therefore you will have to change yourself, you can't change me. शास्त्रम असमंजसम कल्पितम स्यात् वै उपक्रूप संहारे विरोधात् देन स्क्रिप्चर विल बिकम टोटली इनकंसिस्टेंट ड्यू टू द कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन बिटवीन द बिगिनिंग एंड द एंड अनदर रीजन फॉर नॉट एक्सेप्टिंग ब्रह्म वायु पुरुष बद वर्ड ब्रह्मन व्यपदेश अनुपपत्तेश्च देन वाई आर गिविंग द नेम यर ब्रह्म विद्या गिव द नेम टू दिस All portions, Sansari Vidya. Directly say, Sansari Vidya, why you want to name this Brahma Vidya? In the mantra itself, it said, Brahma Vidyaya. Why this mantra is named Brahma Vidyaya then? It should have said there very clearly, Sansari Vidyaya. The name that's been given to this mantra, or the import of this mantra, by the same mantra, is very clearly stating this knowledge of the Supreme Self, not the knowledge of a transmigrating self, but there is no meditation at all. Vyapadesha Anupattesha. यदि च आत्मनि में वेदित संसारी कल्प्येत ब्रह्म विद्येत व्यपदेश न स्यात् आत्मनि वेदिति संसारेण एव वेद्यत्युपपत्तेः। यदि च आत्मनि में वेद इफ इट ट्रांसलेट सेल्फ इज टू बी इंटरप्रेटेड अकॉर्डिंग टू यू कल्प्येत अकॉर्डिंग टू योर इंटरप्रिटेशन इफ यू एक्सेप्ट हियर बाय द वर्ड ब्रह्म एज ब्रह्म भावी संसारी पुरुष transmigrative self, then by the word self you take this, and in this particular sentence atmanam eva ved, the word atmanam means the transmigrative self according to you, then brahma vidyeti vyapadesha nasya, then the name given brahma vidya, the knowledge of supreme self, should not be stated at all. They will not be named as the knowledge of Supreme Self. For what the reason is? Atmanivel, for the reason it would be that in this particular statement, Sansaranev Vidyatupavate, you are accepting the Sansari, it would be logical to say that in this particular statement, if you according to you is a transmigrative self, then the entity known is what? Transmigrative self. When the entity known by this state according to the statement is transmigrative self, the vidya, the knowledge also should be stated as the knowledge of transmigrative self only, not the knowledge of supreme self. If you say by this statement, this particular statement, by the word atman, if you take the supreme self, the known thing will be what? Supreme self. Then the knowledge will be stated as to be of supreme self. Because the name is given depending upon what you are knowing. The known entity. What you are knowing by this, depending on that, the name is given to that particular knowledge. The knowledge of Ghatajnana, why you written Ghatajnana? Because in this statement, Ayam Ghata, the thing known is Ghata, what? Therefore, the knowledge that attained by that particular statement is stated as Ghatajnana. Similarly, in this statement, Atmana Ved, if you say that by the word Atman, the thing that is known is transmigratory self, then the name given to that knowledge should be knowledge of the transmigratory self only, not Brahma Vidya. Further explains, Atma iti, the poor person says in between now, actually in this word Atmanam avet ka, some other person means something else, not himself. You are stating all the time the meaning of this Atmana means he knew itself. You are saying so, Vedanti. But the purpose of the object says, no, Sansari knew some other Atma. Sansari is meditating. I am a Sansari, I am meditating on Atma. I knew that Atma. There is that Atma that is known by a meditation, through meditation, by a Sansari, is different from himself. The meditative Atma, the object of meditation, that Atma is different from the meditator Atma. The meditator Atma is Sansari and the meditative Atma is non-Sansari. Purpaksha says so. Atma iti Veditu Anyat. Who is Vedita? The one who is going to meditate, he is the knower of the object of meditation. And that is different from him, he says. If we say by the word self here, refers to an entity which is other than the knower. Who is the knower? The transmigrative self, Sansari Atma is the knower. And that which is known through meditation, that object is different to him. If this is what you want to say, then Aham Brahmasmi iti chetna, that's not possible. Because Aham Brahmasmi iti visheshana. We'll take the same example. If a thing known is different from the knower, what is the statement they use then? Ayam Ghataha. Because that Ghata is different from me, the knower. Then similarly, if that Atma which is known is different from the knower, then what you should say? I am Atma, not Aham Brahmasmi. I am Brahmasti. Just like I am Ghatasti, you have to say I am Brahmasti. Why you say Aham Brahmasmi? That shows the knower and the known are not different. And if you say the knower and the known are different, then the statement should be I am or so. That is Brahman. Or this is a Brahman. Either one of the two should be that I am Brahman. This cannot be. There's a Bhashakara says, Aham Brahmasmi iti visheshanat, what is your imagination? Impossible. That's impossible. You can't say the knower is different from the known. Or the known is different from the knower. No way you can explain it. Further explains his own statement, Bhashyamala. Aham Brahmasmi iti visheshanat. I am Brahman. This is being characterized by that knowledge is being characterized later. Atmanam eva evet. After this, what the statement comes? It itself, the Shruti is expressing the form of that knowledge. How we came to know it? What is the form of this knowledge? Aham Brahmasmiti. Not I am Brahmasmiti or Asau Brahmastiti. None of that. Anyaschet vedya syat, Bhaskara is explaining. Anyaschet vedya syat, if the entity known is different from the knower, then I am asau iti va visheshata. You should say I am Brahma or asau Brahma. This is Brahman or that is Brahman. This is how you have to characterize the thing. Your own experience. Natu ahamasmiti. You cannot characterize these words. I am that, I am this. The specification that's being done over here, the Shruti is showing the specified experience, Aham Brahmasmi. Instead, it should have specified in this way that this is Brahman or that is Brahman. Any of these two, one of the two should be used by the Shruti. I am Brahmasti, Asau Brahmasti. These are any one of these two statements should have been put forth by the Shruti in this mantra after saying Atmanameva Avet. But what the Shruti said is, after saying Atmanameva Avet, when it started to mention the form of that experience, it stated Aham Brahmasmi and it did not say this is Brahman, I am Brahmasti or Aso Brahmasti. Aham Asmiti Visheshanat Atmanameva Cha Avadharanat. As and because the Shruti, the Upanishad is, because the specification over here by the Shruti, I am this Supreme Self, Aham Brahma Asmi. And also, because the Shruti is with certainty speaking, Eva Avadharana. What is the Avadharana? Atmanam Eva. It knew itself only, alone and nothing else other than it. Avadharana Nishchitam. Atmaiva Brahma iti avagamyate. Therefore, it is very, very clear over here, understood over here, that which has been decided. What has been decided over? Atmaiva Brahma. The Self is itself the Supreme Self. Here, very clear, Bhashyakara. He never used Sansari Atmaiva Brahma. Atmaiva Brahma. Take only the Lakshartha of Tvam, Atma. Tvam. Not antakanavachinnam, any avachinnam, no. Only chaitanyam, that is Brahma. Tathacha sati. Brahma vidya vyapadesha. Tathacha sati upanno. Brahma vidya vyapadesha. Nanyatha. In that case only, if you accept this, in that case only, tathacha sati, the name that has been given over here, in knowledge of the Supreme Brahma vidya, would also be appropriate. Otherwise, what should be the name then? He asks. If according to me, what I am interpreting the meanings over here, if I take that meaning, what should have been the name? Bhashyakara says, Sansari Vidyai Anyata Syat. Otherwise, the name in the other case would be, it is the knowledge of the transmigratory self. It cannot be the name Brahma Vidya. Nacha Brahmatva, Abrahmatvi, Ekasya Upanne. And even in this way you cannot also say that is Brahma and Abrahma both together at the same time. Vishishta Vishishta Vedanta. Vishishta Vishishta Dvaitam. At the same time Vishishta and Avishishta also. Bhashya is telling very clearly over it cannot be so. A thing cannot possess two opposite characteristics at the same time. One should be in reality, the other should be in illusion. Like brightness in sun is reality and darkness is an illusion. Similarly here also, in Brahman, its supreme thing, or superiority in Brahman, that which we experience as self-luminous, self-effulgent, etc., is in its reality. And what we see, the ignorance, etc., that's all an illusion. The Brahmattam is reality, and Abrahmattam is illusion. Ekasya, and if you say in one single thing, both can be together at the same time, without any opposition, without any contradiction, that is impossible. It's a nachapapanne. It's impossible for both of them together to be. That too, paramartata. How it can be possible? Both having the same status of reality. Again, so one is paramarthika satta, the other can be pratitika satta or samadhara satta. You can say it does not matter then. That's possible. But both being paramarthata, that's impossible. Both having absolute reality cannot be accepted at all. Just like the example also. Tama prakasha viva bhanavat vruddhatva. Just like in sun, the darkness and bright cannot coexist in the same time, the same place, in the same way, with equal reality as in the case of a sun. Similar is over here too, he says. Nacha ubhayanimittate brahmityayati nishito vipadesho yukta. And if for a certain time we consider also and let that Brahman be Brahman and Abrahma both, then the Vidya's name would not be Brahmidya. The name should be Brahma Abrahma Vidya. Both. Brahma Abrahmidya should be the name, not Brahmidya also, even then. Nacha ubhaya nimittatve. If both were the cause of the name, nimitta for the name. Ubhaya namna nimittatve. If both are the cause for giving the name, then Brahma Vidyati Nishito Vipadesho Nayatta. Then there should not be a sure specific name that you are mentioning as knowledge of the Supreme Self. Tada! You should have said what then? Brahma Vidya Sansari Vidya Chasyatu Vayamiti. Brahma Sansari Vidya, ya Sansari Brahma Vidya, or Brahma Vidya Sansari Vidya, both. You should say in that way. Then the name should have been, and now it is the knowledge of the Supreme Self and also the knowledge of the transcendental self. But you can't say so. Because the Shrutis, especially the Upanishads, are not meant to cheat anybody. It is proceeding to give the right knowledge of a right thing for liberation purpose. That's why it says, Nacha vastuno ardha jarityatva jarityatvam kalpayitum yuktam Tattva jnana vivakshayam. The Shruti wants to mention about the knowledge of the tattva of this Brahman, of the Supreme Self, of that entity, which is going to give you liberation. And how it can mention that this knowledge is both Brahman and Abrahman? It's just like mentioning this beautiful woman is right half old and left half young. How can a single woman being at the same time old and young in right half and left half portion? On the upper portion she is old and younger, and the lower portion she is young. That division is not possible at all. Similarly, one particular knowledge, according to that too which you are going to wish to mention, he says, how it is, while proceeding to expound the true knowledge of a true entity, which is going to lead you to liberation. Tattva jnana vivakshayam vastunah tattva jnana vivakshayam ardha jaryatvam kalpayitu nayuktam. One cannot here imagine actually the what you are saying, that the present reality is both together in the same thing. Just like one single woman, about women you can't say that half of her body is old and half of her body is young. Similarly, you can't say this knowledge consists of both things. Half of the knowledge is related to, with regard to the Supreme Self, and half of the knowledge is with regard to the transcendental self. You can't say so. Nobody can say so. And if you say so, what's going to happen? I am going to give a special knowledge. The poor objector can say, I am going to give this knowledge to the world from nowadays. So what's going to happen by that? Said, whoever listens your knowledge will fall in under doubts. Shrotu sanshayuhi tatasya. Because that will only cause a doubt in the listener. How is this possible? If anyone listens so, then how can say, how can that be the same thing, giving the knowledge of a thing, and in that thing it will be such an absolute knowledge? How is it possible? Nishchitam cha jnanam purushartha sadhanam ishate. Whereas it is a sure true knowledge only that is regarded to lead us to liberation. Yes, yes, on based on these scriptures I'm telling, a right knowledge leads to liberation and not a doubtful knowledge. A doubtful knowledge leads to destruction. Sanshayatma vinishyati. Smriti says very clearly. Before Shruti gives nishyatam jnanam purushartha sadhanam, for that is Shruti giving yes, yes, yadadha na vichikitsasthi. He who has the proper conviction of the Supreme Self and has not even a little bit doubt in it. Na vichikitsasthi. Vichikitsa means sanshaya. Sanshaya na asti. Then what asti? Adhyasyat. A convicted knowledge is there. Firm conviction is there. A right, sure, perfect knowledge regarding the thing is there. And there is not any trace of doubt in it. That knowledge only, he says, is going to give liberation. Such knowledge only. Whereas this is in Chandogya Upanishad 3.14.4 Sanshayata vinashyati. And Gita 4.40, the doubting person perishes forever. It is Shruti Smriti Bhya. Depending upon these texts of Upanishad and the Smriti, is very clear that a right knowledge only can lead to liberation, and not a knowledge which is a cause of doubts. And if we speak according to your interpretation, then it will lead to doubts only, and you cannot give a conviction. Ato na sanshito vakyartho vachya par hitarthina shrutya. The shruti especially, knowing he has not had a shrutya, I have told that. Because Bhaskara wants to tell in general, any person who wishes good of others. If you wish good to others, then you should never use such a statement and expression which will create doubts in other mind. State only those words which will be clear, which can give a clear meaning and a perfect conviction regarding that particular thing. It's a matter, general matter this is, in this world. It is stated very clearly, a person who wishes to do good to others should not use any expression which creates doubts. So how can Shruti can do so? Therefore, so according to the Upanishad, it is very clear over here by the word of Brahman, you have to be Supreme Self only, not Guru Bhavi Guru Shruti.